What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today we are continuing on my Proxmox journey, setting up my lab. I've had this, you know, video content that I wanted to do for you guys for a long time, and I just didn't pay attention to it. I got lazy a little bit. My Proxmox lab has been up and running for almost, I'll say, a year or so. Today is all about creating a virtual machine, another virtual machine, because if you've been checking out the playlist, my first virtual machine was creating the firewall slash router, which was pfSense. Today, we are creating another virtual machine, which is Windows Server 2022. And we are going to install domain controller. So let's get right into it. So log into your Proxmox server. Within here, we're going to right-click on your data center or cluster. I'm still trying to get myself familiar with the Proxmox terms. But for here, I'm going to right-click where it says BTN HD. Right-click on it. Yes. We're going to select create a VM. We're going to provide a name. This is the name that I'm going to provide it. And the VM ID, I'm going to leave it as 101. And that's also going to be the IP address of the virtual machine. So that's what I've been doing lately. Every time I create a virtual machine within my Proxmox, the VM ID is actually the IP address. So if I create a virtual machine with an ID of 200, that is the IP address that I use. I like that. It's pretty cool. So I'm going to click next. For the OS, I'm going to click on the drop-down menu, and I already pre-populated all the ISO images of my operating systems. I'm going to select the Windows Server Standard Core 2022. I'm going to select it. Awesome. And for the guest OS, the type, I'm going to click on the drop-down, and I'm going to select Microsoft Windows. I left everything as is. I'm going to click on next here. And I unchecked add TPM. And then for the EFI storage, I clicked on the dropdown and I selected VM data store. I clicked on next here. Now for the disk size, by default, it gives you 32 gigs. I increased it to 150. I clicked on next here. For the CPU, I bumped up the socket and the cores to 2 and 2. And I clicked on next. For memory, for my domain controller, I left it as 4 gigs, which is great. I think eventually I upgraded to 16 gigs. I'm going to click next here. For the network, I'm going to click on the bridge. That's going to give you a nice little drop-down menu. I'm going to pick VMBR2, which is the LAN. And if you checked out my pfSense setup within my Proxmox, that little series, the LAN is actually pointing to the pfSense to grab the IP address. So that's what I selected. I'm going to click next here. A nice little summary, confirmation, click on finish, and your virtual machine is configured. One of the things that I did was I went into options. Within options, I selected KVM hardware virtualization, and I clicked on the edit button. So click on that. And I unchecked that to disable it, and I clicked on OK. I went into the console section of my virtual machine, and I clicked on Start Now. It's going to start loading the ISO, so click on any key to boot into the CD or DVD. It's going to start loading the files. It's going to launch this. We're going to click on Next. We're going to click Install. Pick your flavor. I picked standard desktop experience. Click next here. I checked off. I accept the Microsoft software license terms. Click next here. I selected custom install Microsoft Server operating system only. I selected the allocated space. I click next. It's going to start copying the Microsoft Server operating system files. It's going to start getting ready for the installation. Once it's done, once everything is done, you can walk away, come back. It's going to start restarting. Once it restarts, it's going to take you here, provide a password, and re-enter the password. Now, this password is your local password for your local account for the admin, okay? So once you enter that information, just click on finish. It's going to start finalizing the settings, and it's going to take you here. Just log in. Once you log in, your server manager is definitely going to load up automatically because that's the common behavior for servers. I went into local server. Within local server, I located Ethernet and I clicked on IPv4 address assign. That is a hyperlink. So just click on it. It's going to take you here. I selected my Ethernet. I right-clicked on it. I went into properties. I selected Internet Protocol version 4. I clicked on properties. I selected use the following IP address, and I provided a static IP address as well as a DNS server. So I'm going to click OK here. We are going to click OK here. We're going to close this. Let's go back inside the server manager, and I am going to click and locate time zone. So click on that to load this up, because by default, for some reason, it always goes to Pacific time. So I'm going to change the time zone. So click on that, change time zone. Click on the drop down and pick your time zone. For me, Eastern time zone. That's where I'm at, right? So click OK. Click OK. And the last thing that I'm going to do is for the computer name. It's going to generate a computer name. I don't like the computer name, so I'm just going to select the weird WinSP blah, blah that it gave you. Just click on that. Going to launch here. I'm going to go to change, and within change, go into the computer name section and just change it. I called it DC01, domain controller. Click OK. As soon as you click OK, it wants you to restart to apply, you know, the changes. So click OK there, close it. You get another prompt to restart. Click on restart now. It's going to start restarting. Once the machine is restarted, log back into your machine. It's going to launch the server manager again, and we're here. Now it's time for us to get the domain controller up and running, the services. So on the upper right-hand side, we're going to click on manage. We're going to click on roles, add roles and features. Click on it. It's going to load up the wizard. We're going to click next here, next again, and we're going to locate Active Directory Domain Services. Give it a check mark. It wants you to add additional features. Definitely click on add features. Click next here. Click next again. Click next again. I typically like to give a check mark of restart the destination server automatically if required. You're going to get a nice little prompt. Click yes here. Click install. It's going to start installing. And once it's done, it's going to give you this, which is great. Now, right there, it says promote this server to a domain controller. That is a hyperlink. So let's click on that. And the wizard's going to load up. So we are going to select add a new forest. Root domain name, I'm going to provide it the following, btnhd.edu. Woohoo! Click next here. From here, we're going to provide a password and confirm the password for your directory services restart mode. Make sure you jot it somewhere and remember it. For the functional level, for the forest and the domain functional level, I left it as server 2016, and I left everything as is. So I am going to enter all that information. As soon as you enter all that information, just click on next. Click next here. Click next again. I left everything as the default. Click next. A nice little review. Click next. I did get a bunch of warnings, which is okay, but the pre-check did pass successfully, which allows me to continue with the installation. So click on install. It's going to start installing. Give it some time. You will get prompted with this. You're about to be signed out. Just click OK, and it's going to start restarting itself. And once it restarts itself, that's it. You have your domain controller up and running, and just all you have to do is just start testing out your machines. And that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.